What's going on, purpose-driven entrepreneurs? Today, I've got three hacks for FiLMiC Pro that are like secret menu features that you might not know about that you can try out today. So for those of you that aren't familiar with FiLMiC Pro, in case you're new to this channel, then this application is one of my favorite apps for getting manual controls over your video on your phone, above and beyond anything that you can get on an iPhone or an Android device. Having more manual controls in this application means that you can actually control your lighting, exposure, ISO, and all of the stuff that you would expect to find in a higher-end camera that's like a point and shoot. And so you can actually leverage your phone to get the most out of it. So that's why you want to check this app out if you haven't already. So the first hidden feature we're going to cover is focus pull. It's something that they use in cinematography and film, and it's whenever you see a shot where it starts out blurry and then it comes into focus or vice versa. So that's focus pulling, and you can actually pull it off automatically with the FiLMiC Pro app. So let's check it out. So the first thing we're going to do is go to manual controls. And then we're going to use the focus wheel on the right hand side. And then we're going to press and hold on the position where the image is out of focus. So I'm going to hold on the wheel, and that actually creates a marker. Now when I hit this, there's a tiny little down arrow you can tap here, and it automatically adjusts. So the other thing you can control when doing focus pulling is how fast the image comes into focus, which is known as focus pull speed. So you can see as I adjust this little icon on the far right, it's changing the speed up here. It says 7, 6, so I'm gonna leave that right around 6, and then let's test this out. So we'll tap the arrow to go out of focus and then tap the arrow to come back to focus. And you can see how quickly that happens. We can slow that right down. Let's say you were filming in like 60 frames per second or maybe 120 frames per second, and you really wanted to be able to control how fast or how slow the image actually goes into focus or out of focus in post-production when you're editing. So you could do that, and then you could just basically slow down the focus here. So I'm going to tap here. So we're going to pull an image into focus slowly. And that looks like it's still kind of blurry. So we want to make sure that it's nice and sharp. So one thing we can do is we can use the focus pull, and we can make sure that that's actually in focus. Okay, so that feels a bit slow. Let's go up to 5. And we need to make an adjustment here. So we're going to leave the second position here. So I want the full spectrum of the focus wheel. So now I'll tap this arrow. It'll go all the way out of focus. Then you would hit record and simply tap this arrow while you're recording, and the image will come into focus. Try this out with objects, like set an apple on a table or just a single object where you basically just hold it in front of the camera. So the next secret feature I can show you is exposure pull. You can do that with the left-hand side very similarly to what we did with focus pull. So we're gonna set the exposure. First off, when I go into frame rate and I choose 30 frames per second, I wanna make sure also my resolution, I have it set to 4K. Great. So because I'm filming in 30 frames per second, I'm going to make sure the shutter speed is double that, which is 1/60. That's this setting here. So I'm going to lock this in. You can actually tap on that to lock in your shutter speed. It's not something you really want to be changing during your recording. So I always lock the shutter speed. Now it's red and it's locked in. The next thing you can do is very similarly to the focus pull is you can press and hold on this wheel to set a location, two spots for where it's going to change. And again, you can change the exposure pull setting. You can see up here, it says 7, 6. So I'm gonna leave it at 6. So then we would hit the record button, and then you would just tap this wheel. Depending on your device, you may also have an f-stop number at the bottom left corner here. And if you tap this, you can change the opening of the aperture on your camera. This gives you more control over the lighting without impacting your shutter speed. So there's a couple of things when it comes to white balance. If you've ever seen a video where they're like the colors changing, anytime it's in film or like cinema or TV, color grading is huge. So whenever you're watching, like say a Zoom call or something, you're on a Zoom call with someone else and you can see the colors are going from like red to green, different tints, blue. It's because the white balance is set to automatic. And when you're creating your own content, you want to have that turned off. So we're going to lock in our white balance. I'm going to show you a couple of ways to do that in the FiLMiC Pro app. The first method is to move this reticule. And now you can see what's happening on the right. We have our temperature and tint. If we move it left and right, the tint is adjusted. And if we move it up and down, the temperature of the color is changed. And you can also drag them here. And it's moving in increments of 50. So you can still be pretty precise. If I want to go for 5,350 Kelvin, I can. And now, instead of trying to move this wheel and losing my position, I can change this tint here. So now it's at zero. I don't want it to be tinted at all. So that's one quick way to set your white balance. Another way is to use the AWB lock on record. So when you hit the record button, your phone camera will take a reading of the color and it'll automatically set it and keep it locked in. The third hidden feature gives you more control and it is a paid upgrade. But in my opinion, if you're really into improving the image quality of your videos, you may want to consider this. So when we go into this option here in the menu, if you've unlocked with the upgrade, you actually have the option to record with a log format, which means you get more ability to do color grading and modifications to the lighting and colors of your video in post-production. So that's one of the cool features about the FiLMiC Pro app. It's not something you're really gonna see in any other application from what I've actually researched. For your third secret hack, it's actually pretty straightforward. You might already know this one, but you can actually change this display on the bottom of your screen to show a histogram. So you can tap here and then you can set a histogram. That way you're able to see your lighting quality and your levels. And you can actually do an RGB histogram so you're able to see colors as well. And then we actually even have a vector scope in here. So there's some pretty interesting tools that are actually built right in. And that was one of the hidden features that I didn't know about. I'd like to hear from you in the comments below. What is your favorite application or your favorite feature with the FiLMiC Pro app for recording video? If you got any value out of this, then please make sure you smash that thumbs up button and check out this video over here if you'd like to get any more assistance with the FiLMiC Pro app. As always, I want to thank you so much for watching this video, and I can't wait to see you creating a big impact with your videos.